In today's video, I will talk about the best pre-built gaming PCs under $600. Before starting with this video, I want to say that I do not recommend buying these PCs if you want to game at 1080p 60fps on average in games like GTA 5. These PCs are more for office, and if you add RAM to these PCs, you can start gaming at 1080p in some games. Games like Minecraft, Valorant, Fortnite, and League of Legends. For games like GTA 5, it is not going to be the best, but it will average from 30 to 50fps. In low settings. With that being said, I recommend you buying a gaming PC that is at least $680, and you will have the link down below in the description as well with these PCs for you to have it there if you can extend your budget, which is what I recommend doing if you want to start gaming. But if you want a pre-built PC that can game a little bit 720p or 1080p low settings, and you want a PC that is going to be fast for school and work, then this video is for you. Another thing I recommend you doing is buying a PC build instead with these components that you're looking at the screen: the Ryzen 5 5600G, a B55 motherboard, 16 gigs of RAM, dual channel, 2 TB of hard drive, 600 watts of power supply for future upgrades, are around $640. This gaming PC will be much better than these two pre-built PCs that I'm about to mention. But not only that, this gaming PC is upgradable, so you only have to buy a GPU. You can buy it now or when GPUs come back to the normal price, and you will be able to get like a 1660 Super for $300, and that will make a huge difference. But now let's start with the pre-built gaming PCs. With the first one and the cheapest one, we have this HP Pavilion Gaming Desktop TP01 1055M PC. This one is $500 and has 8 gigs of RAM at dual channel, 1 TB of hard drive, 256 GB of SSD, which is great for school and office because you can put Windows on the SSD, and it has integrated graphics with the AMD Ryzen 3 4300G. Like I said before, if you have a 720p monitor, this PC will have an alright gaming experience at more than 90 FPS average in competitive games. But if you go to 1080p, this PC will still be alright with competitive games at 60 FPS average. What I recommend you doing if you don't have the budget right now is upgrading the RAM in the future to 16 gigs, so swapping these 2 sticks of 4 gigs and putting 2 sticks of 8 gigs. So overall, for the price that you're paying, is a pretty decent pre-built PC. I couldn't find a better deal for 500, but I couldn't expect a much better experience. So if you have 500 and you can't go up to those $680, then this PC is for you. And the next one is $600, but it's upgradable, and that's why it's the number one of this video. It has the AMD Ryzen 5 3400G, which it has an alright integrated graphics, 8 gigs at 3200 MHz, 240 GB of SSD, so you will eventually need to upgrade the storage as well, and 550 watts of power supply. So in the future, you will have to upgrade the RAM to 16 gigs, the storage with 1 TB of hard drive if you can't afford the SSD, and with the GPU, which is really expensive right now, and that's why for $80 more, you can get already a pre-built PC with GTX 1650 Super, which will be a much better deal if you want to start gaming right now. Remember that you have that deal down below in the description. So for the conclusion of this short video, if you want a pre-built PC right now, you can't go up to $680 at the bare minimum. You can buy these two PCs and play at 720p or even 1080p at the lowest settings in some games. If you have a question about which games these gaming PCs can run, you can leave your game in the comment section and I will reply with the FPS average that you can expect from these PCs. Once again, I recommend you the PC build if you want to upgrade it in the future. If you don't want to build it by yourself, I recommend the Elite Gaming Essential PC, which was the number one because it's upgradable as well and it's a pre-built already, so you will only have to put the GPU. And if you want to start gaming right now and you can extend your budget to $680, I recommend buying the other gaming PC that I leave down below in the description, where you can play competitive games at 1080p more than 100 FPS average, which is a huge upgrade from these two PCs. Leave in the comment section as well what do you want to see next, and leave me your pre-build or PC build, and I will make a video about what you can change or if it's alright. Thank you guys for watching, and if you have a higher budget than $600, maybe like $1,000 or a little bit less, you can watch my video about the best pre-built gaming PCs under $1,000 by clicking in the top right of the screen. And if you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please leave a like and subscribe, but most importantly, hit the bell button so you get notified when I upload this type of content. And I know this video was short, but that's because there are not a lot of deals for 600 or less. Thank you guys for watching, thank you for the support, and I will see you on the next one.